Hi and welcome to the Stippleism tutorial. I'm Alice and in this episode I'll give you the rundown on dot colour settings for stipple. Overall we'll cover dot colour, sample object and overprint. This artwork heavily relies on the colour settings for our traditional stipple. If I zoom in, you can see the level of detail that's been created with layers of colour. In order to produce this radiating effect, I've used a radial gradient. Let's go ahead and apply a new stipple to this one. So all the colour settings are located here at the bottom of the dot settings. Colour is pretty self-explanatory as it just means the colour setting for the dot. Let's apply it to this simple gradient. As you can see, default is black. If I just click on the black swatch, up pops the colour picker where you can select your chosen colour. I like to use swatches, so let's click the colour swatches button. Select the colour and OK to save. This setting alone can transform your artwork, such as this skull, with a sort of blueprint effect. Let's switch to this snow leopard for the next bit. I've purposely made this pixelated to demonstrate how a stipple can sharpen low-res images. Let's open up the stipple already applied. As you can see, it's using the default black colour. If we select the colour setting sample object this time, make sure preview is selected, wait for it to apply. It might not be obvious at this size, but the dots take on the underlying colour and are uniformly applied across the image. So where previously there were no dots for any white sections, you now have a constant fill of dots. This effect is more akin to pointillism and definitely has more potential to look painterly. The density can be increased as before, meaning more dots and fewer gaps. As with any of these settings, be aware that adding a colour will increase processing time and remember how much work the plugin is doing for you. What you could also do is apply a colour gradient to the object, which will then be transferred to the stipple with the setting. The last colour setting is overprint, which is very relevant for any work you intend to print. Don't worry too much as it kind of needs a tutorial of its own. If you're unsure, keep this ticked and watch our overprint tutorial. We have reached the end of this tutorial. Just to recap, you now know how to change the dot colour, how to sample object, as well as adjust the overprint. Unsure of whether stippleism is right for your workflow? Just try our free 14-day trial. Thanks for watching.